Hey everyone, today I got a really cool project for us to do, and that is we're going to be upgrading our gaming desktop computer. So I got this basically a year ago to the day. It's actually a used rig. I'm pretty frugal when it comes to like buying stuff just for like entertainment. So like if it's my MacBook Pro for work, I'll obviously buy that new and spend a ton of money. For a gaming desktop, I'm like, I'm just playing games on it. $500, what's the best I can get? So I got this really awesome HP Omen gaming desktop. It was like 450 euro, and that was a really good deal because it had like a 7th generation Intel i5 processor, a GTX 1060, and at the time I did put a small SSD into it, just one of those really cheap 120 gigabyte ones. But a year has passed, so I was like, let's do some upgrades on the desktop. So what we got here is a 500 gigabyte NVMe SSD. So this will be an upgrade from the SATA one. I don't know how much faster it's going to be, but it's PCIe, so it's going to be somewhat faster. I was debating between this and the Samsung 970 Evo. However, what made me go for this, to be honest with you, is that there, I think there is going to be a ceiling to performance of what we can do with this gaming desktop. It's a 7th gen Intel processor, so it's the H270 chipset. And that means like I'm never going to be able to put like a 6-core or an 8-core or any new processors in there because it's a different socket. Like if I'm going to be putting like a new graphics card into it, I probably want a new processor too, which at that point means just getting a new gaming desktop. So we're going to put an upgrade that makes sense for it. So this was like a good compromise between speed and storage capacity. Likewise, I picked up another 8GB memory stick, so we'll go from 8 to 16. I was contemplating doing 32, just in case I wanted to experiment with doing video on it. But again, quad-core processor, there's going to be just a bottleneck there if I actually try to edit on it. I prefer editing on Mac anyway, but like, why would you even bother? So I think 16GB with this upgrade stick is going to be like a good, solid upgrade. And then just for the lulz, I also picked up a new USB-C thumb drive. I love these from SanDisk. This is the 120GB version. I have a 60GB version. These are great, and you are going to need a USB stick for this tutorial because we need to install Windows 10 off an ISO. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing we need to do is prep the computer. So there are two things you're going to want to download. Mainly Windows 10 USB installation creator. You can find that from the Microsoft website. There's a link in the description below. And you also want to download a program called CC Cleaner. It's a really good free tool. And we're actually going to do it just to make a list of the programs we have installed on our computer, just so that when we transfer over, we know what we need to reinstall. Because I'm going to go for a clean installation to take advantage of the new NVMe. I don't want to carry any baggage over onto it. So we're going to just reinstall everything from scratch. But it's nice to have a list to let us know what we're going to need. So once you create a USB flash drive, the process is very simple. Like Microsoft walks you through it step by step. It's foolproof. You can even select, you know, if it's for this computer, which it is, which makes things even easier. So it selects the right version of Windows for you. So once that's done, the next thing you're going to want to do is back up all the files on your computer. Again, I'm going to do this to my new USB stick. And what I'm going to transfer over is basically like my documents, my photos, all my game saves for my computer games, all the settings. Now, if you want to copy your user file over, you can certainly do that. You can back up and transfer over to a new drive using something like the backup facility in Windows settings. But I'm going for a clean transfer as possible, so I'm just going to copy everything over from my documents folder. I'm pretty happy to let everything else go. We're going to unbox the SanDisk thumb drive. This is very exciting. So we're going to rip it open like so. Again, I really like these. So the thing that's really cool about these is that they're dual-sided, so there's both a USB side and there's also a regular USB-A side. There's actually USB-C on the HP Omen built in. I don't have to add like a PCIe card to the back of it where it's hard to reach. There's actually like USB-C built into the I/O, and I believe it's USB-C 3.1, so it's really fast. So that was like why, another reason why this computer was such a steal for me. But again, it's very handy that this has USB-A because it's a thumb drive. You never know where you're plugging it into, and that might be an older computer. So we're gonna go ahead and transfer these files now. So one thing that I actually am gonna back up are my OBS settings, because I took absolutely ages making these. So I'm gonna export this from OBS, and oh, it's just a JSON file. Brilliant. And I'm just going to export this. So that's going to be a huge help for me because I spent absolutely hours setting up OBS and getting all my scenes together for all my different recordings I do, whether it's from an Elgato capture card, whether I'm recording from a webcam. You do not want to lose your OBS settings if you're a streamer. So now that you have your computer prepped, it's basically time for a surgery. So before we get started, I'm actually going to use an air can and spray off some of the dust because this is really dusty. Let's give it a spray. That's pretty damn dusty. Yes, now we're talking. So something that's really cool about the HP Omen desktop is that there's actually like these hard drive cages, but I think it's really cool that you can actually just stick hard drives in and out of it. And this reveals the tower. So this is our guts of our computer. As you can see, they are appropriately dusty. So we're gonna go ahead and give it just a spring cleaning. We're almost basically in the summer at this point, but who's counting? So just spraying in short bursts, trying to make sure that the can doesn't spray any moisture into the system, because obviously you do not want moisture on your computer. There's definitely some on the graphics card. You can actually see, this is the hard drive cage I was telling you about. This is where the hard drives go. And this is where my little 120GB SATA SSD was. And by the way, it was a good SSD. I am actually mostly upgrading it for capacity because I'd like to keep a few games on an SSD, like the ones I'm currently playing. So now that we sprayed out the system with air, we're basically going to go ahead and install our upgrades and maybe remove the turbo paste and put in fresh code on. And it already has 8GB in DIMM 2. We're going to put our second DIMM in DIMM 4, the other red one. We're going to remove the 120GB SSD there and put in our new Western Digital 500GB NVMe in that M2 slot there. So we're going to go out and take out the RAM. Snap it in like that and open up our SSD. And this is the Western Digital M.2 500GB NVMe SSD. And we are just gonna tighten it in like so. So we're gonna go ahead and remove the CPU cooler so that we can change the thermal paste. So we're using some Arctic MX4 thermal compound. I'm not a thermal paste expert, so please note I have absolutely no ambition beyond not blowing up my computer. So I probably am doing this wrong, and I really recommend you watch someone else how to apply thermal paste. I hope this is enough. That has to be enough. That's what like, it looks like on the internet. Oh lads, if it's any more than this, I'm screwed. I'm gonna leave it at this. I'm too afraid to put any more in. You guys think that's too much or too little? I think that's a healthy amount, I think. Look, it can't be any more than that. I don't think it's any less. Me, don't even ask how that happened. So I legit got it like everywhere. So this is like a rescue operation now. Lads, look, if this computer doesn't turn on, I'm sorry. I really tried to clean up as much of it as possible. So can you tell a Mac user is doing this upgrade? All right, so I basically have everything in it at this point. I'm too traumatized. I reconnected the CPU cooler. So one thing that I am gonna do is I'm gonna disconnect the 120GB SSD. Let's install Windows onto our new SSD using that thumb drive I created earlier. So we're going to power this back up, and hopefully I didn't ruin my system, because this would be a terrible time for it to happen when we're all stuck at home and nothing to do. Oh, perfect. So we're in Windows 10, so it looks like my computer did not blow up. So let's go ahead and install Windows 10. Yep, that's our new SSD, our 500GB. And let's just press next, and this will go ahead and install. Okay, so we're back to this. All we need to do is put in our 1TB mechanical hard drive back into the computer case. So let's go ahead and take this off yet again. So this should be much quicker. I'm probably gonna put it in the top cage for easy access. Oh, perfect. So that's super convenient. Like they don't even have to be screwed in. They just kind of like slot in like so. I just need to connect the power like so, and also connect the ATA cable. Perfect. That's all we actually have to do. Pretty simple. Still dust. Some of this dust never leaves. And all we have to do now is put our case back on. The tricky bit is going to be configuring the BIOS to make sure it doesn't boot into Hewlett Packard's recovery, and that just boots into our NVMe drive that we just installed there. So this is a great opportunity for me to clean the case and just give it a wipe. I mean, I'm really just trying to make sure that we don't find Miss Corona on this. Or do they call me Miss Rona? I'm pretty happy with that. Ooh. So it's been about 24 hours since I recorded that video. It's the next day. And yeah, the computer is fully up and running. Everything is working great. I'm very happy with how it turned out.
As you can see, here is our specy, and here you can see that we've got the 16 gigabytes of RAM now compared to 8, and we have our new 500 gigabyte SSD. So I'm very happy with how it all turned out, and apparently my computer didn't blow up, even though there was that thermal paste accident. But I won't say anything if you won't. Okay, so we're doing some Apex Legends now, and keep in mind, I am not an Apex gamer. I haven't played this like in over a year. Oh, where the hell are we? This is running at 1080p because I'm also recording this in OBS at the same time. At 1080p, look, the bottleneck, frankly, is the graphics card. The CPU is fully at 100% and the GPU is about 94%. I'm like just looking for a gun because I'm talking to the camera. I can't concentrate on my gameplay. What am I even doing? Oh, thank God I got a gun. Okay, I'm gonna come over and try and help you. Just know I'm not putting my heart into this. Playing on a wireless keyboard and mouse is so... Oh my God, I actually killed someone. Apex is like my game. Oh, I'm dead. Well, that was just... So, what we observed from that Apex match was that the graphics card again was running fully at 100%. So was the CPU. So as I said before at the start of my video, like I only wanted to do practical upgrades because if I really wanted, you know, to get really good performance from things like gaming or video editing, I'd have to get a new CPU and a new GPU. But we still did get some performance benefit because the RAM spiked to about 8.2 gigabytes, which means, you know, it blew past the original 8 gigabyte stick that I had in the system. So 16 gigabytes is definitely a good fit for this system. So let's do a speed test of the new SSD. As I said before, I'm very happy with the performance. It's writing there right now. So as you can see, the read speeds are about 2000 megabytes, the writes are 1500 megabytes. I'm very happy with those speeds for this computer. I think my MacBook Pro does read and write faster than that, but again, I'm very happy with that. So if those are speeds that you'd be kind of into, then I highly recommend the Western Digital SSD, because again, it's about the same price of a 970 Evo, but you get like double the capacity. So it's like better value in that sense. So, you know, it's very fast, I feel like, for day-to-day things. And like for the games that I play, like The Sims is gonna run so well on this new SSD, but I'm not gonna show you me playing The Sims. You can go to my Twitch channel if you want to see me play The Sims. I feel like if you're watching this video, you're probably not into The Sims, but you know, not everybody's the same and I like The Sims. So as I said before, I bought this machine on the cheap. I wasn't sure how much I was going to gain. And you know, 1 year later, I feel like I got a good value from that. And I just wanted to put like a good incremental upgrade onto the system. It's obviously a very fast machine. It's just knowing obviously where the bottlenecks are going to be on the system. But I'm pretty happy with this upgrade and how that turned out. I hope you guys are too. And I hope you guys found this video entertaining, because I don't know how informative it was, because again, I'm not an expert at upgrading machines. I'm a Mac man, I'm pretty proud, but overall, I love computers, whether it's Windows or Mac, it's whatever gets the job done for me, and that's why I have both systems. So if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to see more technology videos and hit that notification bell. And leave a comment below on how you thought this upgrade went. Are you planning on doing any upgrades to your own computer? And well, I really don't want to. I know I'm not good at Apex Legends, but not a pro gamer. Sims is my game. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys have a very nice day. Bye.